is the difference between Redondo Beach and Palos Verdes? Now, after so many years of being in real estate, I hear this question all the time. I've broken down my six main differences between Redondo and PV. Now, if you haven't already, please hit subscribe. Every week, new videos, South Bay, Palos Verdes, talking about the local area as well as real estate. And you know, if you are planning to make a move here in the next 2 years, please feel free to reach out to me. I have my contact info linked below. I would love to say hi and introduce myself and hear a little bit about how I can be your real estate advisor as you make your move in the next couple of years. All right, so first thing, and in my opinion, I think this is the biggest difference between choosing Redondo Beach and Palos Verdes, and that is going to be walkability. Now, I always tell my clients when they're looking to purchase, what kind of lifestyle do you want? Do you want to be, you know, close to the beach and be able to walk to restaurants and schools? Or do you want to, you know, have maybe a little bit more peace and quiet, a little less traffic, a little less noise? And those are the biggest differences to me about what makes Redondo Beach special and what makes Palos Verdes special. Palos Verdes is going to be much quieter. You're going to need a car to live there. Walkability is very small. You're located up on a hill. There's other pros to this, obviously, which we'll go through, but overall, I would say those are the main differences. If you want walkability, Redondo Beach is going to be the better option. If you don't mind driving pretty much everywhere you go, then Palos Verdes is going to be, you know, a great option for you as well. Second thing is more bang for your buck. So if you are looking for a big home on a big lot, you are more likely to get this in Palos Verdes than you are in Redondo Beach. Now, that is not to say that you can't find it in Redondo. Yes, you can. But in terms of price per square foot, Palos Verdes does tend to be more affordable than Redondo Beach. So the homes do tend to be a little bigger. The lots definitely on average are larger than Redondo Beach. So if you're looking to have more space, I would say Palos Verdes is going to be the way to go versus Redondo Beach. Third thing is views. If you are moving here to the South Bay or you already live here and you want views, then Redondo Beach is not gonna be as great of an option compared to Palos Verdes. You're gonna wanna go with Palos Verdes. Palos Verdes, like I said, is perched up on a huge hill and has massive views looking out over the ocean, the Queen's Necklace, and you know, even some city LA views, just depending on which side of that hill you are located on. And if you check out some of my PV videos, I talk more about the specifics on that in the Palos Verdes videos and which cities have views depending on where they are located. Now, that is not to say you can't get views in Redondo Beach, because you can, but Redondo Beach is much more flat. There are some streets that are peaked up on a hill. They have some peekaboo views. Sometimes there's good ocean views, especially if you're up front on the Esplanade, but overall views, you're going to be better off picking Palos Verdes. Number four, beach access. While Palos Verdes is a peninsula, right? So it's surrounded by water. A lot of the beaches are inaccessible. And if you are able to take the little hike down to get to it, they're rocky beaches oftentimes. So there's not a lot of sandy beaches in Palos Verdes. There's some, but overall, especially if you want to participate in like surfing or swimming, oftentimes you're going to prefer Redondo Beach. If you want to be able to have walkability to the beaches, be able to ride your bicycle on the Esplanade, you know, have really close proximity to the beach, Redondo is going to be the better option. It's a little bit of a drive depending on where you're located in Palos Verdes to get down to the sandy beaches. So definitely Redondo if you prefer to be at the beach. Number five, freeway access. This one's going to be a little bit tough, okay? Both Redondo and Palos Verdes are pretty deep into the South Bay areas. So both have more difficult freeway access unless you're located in the North Redondo area. I would check out the North Redondo versus South Redondo video for specifics on this. But if you're in South Redondo, it can take 20 to 30 minutes to get to the freeway. Your closest freeway will be the 405, which takes you up to, you know, West LA or down to Orange County and beyond. And then if you're in Palos Verdes, usually, interestingly enough, the closest freeway access to you is the 110. So if you need access to get downtown or anywhere up north that direction, then living in PV would most likely be a better option. But overall, I would say in general, they both don't have great freeway access. Number six, nightlife and restaurants. Now, if you are the type of person who loves to eat and you are, you know, going out like to Uber all the time to get to dinner and go out and have fun, nightlife bars, a little bit more of a scene, Redondo Beach is going to be a much better option for you than Palos Verdes. Palos Verdes is known for being an extremely sleepy, slower paced kind of town. And so restaurants aren't usually that close in proximity. There aren't that many restaurants. And if you know you're gonna be going out trying to enjoy nightlife, you're gonna need to take an Uber, then you're going to wanna be more in the beach cities areas. Some places in Palos Verdes, it's a little difficult to access Uber. And even having like groceries and things delivered, sometimes that can be a challenge depending on how deep or far into Palos Verdes you are. So that is something to definitely keep in mind. If you're someone who is still really active and going out a lot, I would say Palos Verdes may not be the best option for you. But if you are done with that, you like to eat at home, things kind of quiet, then Palos Verdes might be a great option. Overall, those are the main differences to me between Palos Verdes and Redondo Beach. Now, one added little bonus, both have amazing school districts. So you can't go wrong with the schools depending on Redondo or Palos Verdes. Both of them really great school districts. So that's a win-win either way. Now, thank you so much for checking out my Redondo versus Palos Verdes video. I have many videos covering both Redondo and Palos Verdes, but I would be really interested to hear which is your favorite area, Redondo or Palos Verdes, and leave it in the comments. Again, I'm Carissa Wright, and if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to reach out to me. I have my contact info linked below. And again, my cell phone is 310-905-5774. Thanks so much. And if you haven't already, don't forget to hit subscribe. See you next time.